I'm here with Liam Smith, the coach of the New South Wales team, and you've had two great wins by some of your players this morning. Tell me about those competitions and their preparation leading up to this event.
Okay, well, the boys have been working hard in preparation. Had a good physical warm-up this morning and a very good hit. It was good rest yesterday. We had a little bit fortunate. We had a fairly easy draw yesterday in terms of the opponents that we played, so we were able to rest our number one player, which was good. And then the matches this morning were pretty hard-fought matches, actually, even though they were both two sets. The first match in the second set, it got pretty tight where the opponent broke back, and the boy from Victoria actually got on a pretty good streak there and started to play some really good tennis. So kind of happy to come through that one in two sets. And then again here in this one, we had a good start, and Will was off to a good start, and things changed through the course of that second set, and his opponent started to get a little bit more rhythm, started to play a little bit better, and again, pretty happy that we got through in that tie break. It was a little tight there a few times, so that was a pleasing result for sure.
Very good. Tell me about the event in general. How have you see it going with all the teams coming in from all the Australian provinces and states? And how do you see the rest of the week playing out as far as your particular group is concerned?
I have to double check the rules, but I think that most likely we'll probably go through now having two wins. So I guess it depends on doubles results and our next result as to if we go through as the number one or two team and as to who we play next. So I think either way, when you get to the semi-final stage, it doesn't really matter who went through first or second. It's game on. So I think it's actually a great event. It's my first year being here to do the event, and I think it's actually nice that all the kids can come from the different states and be a part of a team, and gives us coaches an opportunity to get on the court and spend some time with them and talk to them during the matches, which we don't get to do all year. So it's actually a valuable learning experience as well for the players, and I think it's nice for them. You know, you never know, some of the players in the future might play Davis Cup or Junior Davis Cup and then Davis Cup, so it's a little bit of a team environment. It's nice. So
looking forward to next week, do you have any tips for us of players to watch as the championships unfold?
In the 14s?
That's right.
In the 18s, yeah. I mean, there's a lot of good players, obviously, in the 18s. The two strongest players you'd see would be Ash Barty and Luke Saville, who obviously are the Wimbledon champions, which would be, it's nice to see them playing the 18s event and supporting that, which is great. And then in the 14s, there's some strong players in the field as well. So, you know, I think, unfortunately, a couple of the stronger players have gone over to play some events in the US, which is, you know, very good for their development. But we still have a strong field here in the 14s. I'm hoping to see some good matches, and I think that there's a boy from Victoria, Mark Polmans, and the boy that I have on the New South Wales team, Jake Delaney, that will be quite strong in the girls 14s, and then in the boys 14s, and then in the girls 14s you've got Sarah Tomic and some of the other stronger players from Queensland. So it'll be an interesting week, I think.
Liam, thanks very much for your time today, and good luck for the rest of the tournament.
Thank you, appreciate it.